Yeah, it's on. Yeah.
It's on? All right. Parashat Pinchas. Parashat Pinchas. Vayidaber Hashem el Moshe lemor. The Torah tells us then that God has spoken to Moshe. And let me just wait. And it says, it's a very interesting line. Pinchas ben Elazar ben Aaron HaKohen. Now, Pinchas, the son of Elazar the Kohen. Heshiv et chamati me'al bnei Yisrael. So first of all, a question needs to be asked. I'm not going to answer this now. I'm going to focus on something else. What does it mean, heshiv et chamati? Why, he made my anger come back. So what does it mean, heshiv et chamati? It should say, kibay chamati, he made me cool off. What is heshiv et chamati? You know, chamati also my mother-in-law, yeah? You see the parallel over there? By the way, this shiur is Le'ilui Nishmat Uven Leib Ben Chana. So it is, it said from Bnei Yisrael, how? Bekono et kinati betocham, ve'lo kiliti et Bnei Yisrael bekinoti. And I would not whack the Jews because I got angry. He kind of calmed me down. Therefore, lachen emor, therefore say, hineni noten lo et briti, shalom. Therefore, I'm giving my covenant of shalom, whatever shalom would be. Of course, the question is, why did Pinchas was rewarded with this covenant of shalom? What is the connection between Pinchas to the shalom that was given to him? Apparently, it's something that was given to him. So the Ibn Ezra, Rabbi Abraham Ibn Ezra, for example, understood that the covenant of shalom was meant to save Pinchas from the brothers of Zimri ben Salu, and the reason is it says, "Ve'atam shelo yagor mi'achez Zimri ki hu nasi bet av." Basically, they were, according to the Ibn Ezra, they were concerned from some kind of like blood feud. And therefore his family will go and will kill him. So therefore HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, you know, I'm going to give him a certain protection. So therefore, I mean, which is very interesting, if you're saying that, so you see that shalom is really a form of protection, not a form of what we call peace. And you see, I'm trying to avoid the word peace. Eliyahu Navi, can you turn off the phone, please? Okay, so now, the Natsiv also in He'amek Davar also understood that this covenant of Shalom was meant to save Pinchas. But according to him, which is mind-blowing, it was meant to save Pinchas from? Pinchas, from himself. Yeah. If you need a recommendation for a book, for a sefer, among many other things I could recommend to you, try to get the He'amek Davar for the Natsiv. It's a tremendous sefer. I had it and I lost it, but, you know. So, Kachu Kotev, and it says, Et Briti Shalom, my covenant of Shalom, Besachar She'iniach Ka'aso V'chamato Shel HaKadosh Baruch Hu, right? The fact that he was able to calm the situation down or bring the anger. Chema is anger. So he was able to bring that anger back into its source of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And in return, Shelo Yakpid Velo Yargi, so that's not going to, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is not going to be very particular with us. And it says, Ubishvil Kiteva HaMaaseh, and because of the nature of the action that Pinchas did, laharog nefesh bayado, to kill a person with his own hand, haya noten lashir balev hergesh az gam achar kach. To take the life of a person in your hands, it is something that you can't just dismiss. I spoke to someone who told me that he had a big fight with someone, you know, like one of those bar brawls that they had. And he said he almost killed the person. He felt his life is going out of his body. And said then he was petrified. People tried to pull him. They didn't. But when he almost. He said it's a terrible thing. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave him that according to that, to be able to create some kind of a balance. Aval ba'asher haya l'shem shamayim, but because the act of Pinchas was l'shem shamayim, mishum hachi, because of that, ba'a habracha sheye tamid benachat uvemidat ha'shalom. Because he did what he did for the sake of heavens, of the honor of heavens, therefore he gave him a certain blessing that it is always going to be in a state of tranquility and harmony. And that is not going to be the fact that he took somebody's life. It's not going to be something that is going to change his heart or go to some stain in his soul. So the act of jealousy of Pinchas, which killed with what? How did he kill it? He killed with a romach. Mazer romach?
Spear.
Spear or javelin?
Javelin.
There is a big difference between the two.
Javelin's a long spear. Uh-huh. It's just a longer spear?
Yes. One is kidon. Kidon is shorter, and romach is the long one. So it says, and he killed with this romach, and pay attention to the word romach. He killed two people, so for sure it was for L'shem Shamayim. And why? Because of jealousy to Hashem. He couldn't understand that somebody will do such a thing. And in a holy camp of Am Yisrael, when Hashem dwells among you, to do such a thing, he said it was impossible for him. Afal Piken, he says, the teva umaaseh, the action, the core of the action itself, it could become make Pinchas into a very cruel person. That's why he gave him the bracha. In other words, when he's going to be in nachat v'shalom, he's going to be in internal harmony and in internal tranquility. In other words, not to develop this kind of quality inside of you. That's why you want to have to be careful. And I told you this many times. I do believe that the excess violence that we have in our society is due to the increase in realism of violence that we expose in films and movies. I mean, I could still watch John Wayne movies and to see that ketchup stain on his clothing and still be okay because, you know, it doesn't bother me that it's not real. But slowly, slowly, you see how it came out. To the point that today people are paying money to go see, they call it mixed martial arts, right? To see it, and to see people basically beaten up to a pulp, which is a horrible thing. Yeah, I know, it stopped, yeah. So therefore, also, however, internal peace and internal tranquility could be of a danger, could be dangerous also. We always think that bad qualities are bad. But is there a possibility that good quality or good, you know, good deed or good habit could also become bad? And we never think about it this way. Of course, if I'm too good, let's say, for example, there are some refugees in the world, and they all want to come here to the land of the free, the home of the brave. At what point do I allow people, as let's say, for example, refugees to come in and to host them here? And to one point, that becomes a burden to society, to the point of society collapse. I mean, look at California. The whole health system in California collapsed because everybody can go in. It's free for all. Americans will have to pay money. Immigrants get it for free. Or illegal immigrants get it for free. Or education, and so on and so forth. In other words, it has to be correct or not correct. I mean, and so therefore, a good deed could become, in a way, also bad. So how this midah of shalom, of internal harmony, could become bad? Because it could turn into apathy. That midah could turn into apathy, and this is exactly, by the way, what happened to Pinchas. That's what happened to Pinchas. According to the Natziv, based on the Gemara, that says the following. Amar Rav Yehuda, Amar Shmuel. Rav Yehuda says the name of Shmuel. The Amar Krada, the Pasuk says in Bamidbar Chafei Yud Beit. Lachen hemor, inni noten lo briti shalom. I give him his peace shalom. Kishehu shalem. When is there going to be? When he's going to be whole. Velo kishehu chaser. And not when it's missing or it's not whole. Veha shalom k'tiv. It says the word shalom. So Amar Rav Nachman, Vav the Shalom Ketiyahi. In the Vav of Shalom, there's a little separation. In most Sefer Torah, should I say?
The Sfaradim
don't have it. Nusach Sfarad, Nusach Ashkenaz have it.
This week I thought the Sefer Torah was possible because it didn't have it.
Yeah. So, and it says that. And that's why, as we said, the letter of Vav of Shalom is Ktiyah. And that's, by the way, that's in, we learned this in Masachet Kiddushin, Dav Samech Vav Amud Bet. It brings it over there, at the end of the day. So since Pinchas, and what was that? Since Pinchas became, whatever. He became like a whatever person. When? During the time of the Shoftim. He wasn't the same Pinchas. He was in a tranquil state of mind. In the time of the Shoftim. Why? Because it says the Bame Sheaya Bemidat HaShalom, the Natziv says, Yoter miHaraui, more than what is appropriate. Shelokina Bime HaShoftim Al Pesel Micha. On the statue of Micha, there was an idol, became an idol. He didn't protest against that. Umishum Achiktiv Ktia. Shalom is separate, then ne'enash, ve'nimtza demidat ha-shalom nehefach lo leroetz. And the quality of shalom became a bad thing for him. It was a stumbling stone, a block for him. It's mind-boggling. And so is the Midrash says in Tanud ve'Eliyahu, Parasha Yud Bet, in the Yakut Shimoni, Im Shuftin, Resh Mem Zayin, Samech Amud Beit. And he says the following, Im Tomar Otam Shanim, those when they had the case of Pilegesh Bagiva, Mipnei ma nehergu, why they were killed? Ayalahem, what they're saying is ay. It's so hard. It says Ayalahem le Sanhedrin Gdola, Sheiniach Moshe veYehoshua uPinchas ben Elazar imahem. It was appropriate for the great Sanhedrin that it was established by this great people. Shekshiru chavalim shel barzel bemotneim, that they should put strong rope on their hips, roll up their skirts. They weren't transgender, chas v'shalom. They were just wearing those like robes, right? Ve'yagbiu bigdeim lemala me'arkubutehem, and they should lift it up high. Ve'yachazu bechol arayorotehem shel Yisrael, and they should go every single day for a different town where Jews are dwelling. Yom echad le'Lachish, yom echad le'Eglon, yom echad le'Chevron. By the way, you see, Chevron belongs to the Jews. Yom echad le'Bet El, go from place to place. Yom echad le'Yerushalayim, ve'yelamdu otam derech eretz b'shana. Beshtaim, Beshalosh, Be'arba, Bechamesh, and they should teach them Torah during this time that they were conquering the land. Ad sheyit yashvu Yisrael be'artzam, until the Jews would settle down the land. And then, only then, it gadal v'itkadash me'rabba.
Amen.
No, amen. Amen. It's like the same thing when we read Parashat Tzitzit. Ani Hashem Elokechem, everybody says Amen. The guy is reading the Torah, everybody says Amen. I'm sorry. It's all automatic, right? Only then. And they didn't do it. Ela, kevan shenichnesu Yisrael le'artzam, since the Jews entered the promised land, it was, by the way, promised to the Jews, not to any other choleras. Kol echad ve'echad, each and every one. What did they do? Ratz le'karmo ve'lezeito. each one goes to his own vineyard and to his own olive trees. Ve'omer, shalom alai nafshi, shelo le'arbot ha'torach. Oh, that's it. I don't care. You know, I can't be busy with other stuff. Leave me alone, no. I have patience for that. Kind of a thing. U'kesh'asu be'givat binyamin drachim mechoarim, when they did inappropriate and you know, despicable things in the hills of Binyamin, ve'dvarim she'enam ruim, which is not appropriate to do, yatza kadosh baruch hu le'achriv. Kadosh baruch hu went to destroy what? The whole entire world. Le'achriv ha'olam kulo. Ve'naflu me'em 72,000. 72,000 people died. And then the Midrash says, umi harag otam? And who killed them? Sanedri gdola she'eniach Moshe ve'Yoshua u'Pinchas imahem. Over there. This is the one. So in a way, Sanhedrin should have taught them, and because of that, Sanhedrin would had to execute them. And this is a musar to all of us to contribute, to give, to understand that that's the true meaning of our life. This is for all of us who are teaching people or guiding people, not to say, okay, I got my position, that's it, shalom alecha nafshi, I don't care, yalla. First thing I do after I got my position, let me get chains and locks, let me tie myself to the chair, and I'm going to, everything I'll do is to continue my position here in the chair, not to actually do what I need to do. Give the people tochecha, guide them. Don't worry about yourself. Don't just worry about your paycheck. Worry about the kavod of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Don't tell the people what the people want to hear. Tell the people what the people need to hear. And if you cannot do that, don't be a rabbi. Your rabbi is not your friend. Your rabbi is your teacher, is your guide, is your eyes. He's your beacon that guides you. Do you want a guide that would flash the light at you or away from you? He'll tell you where to go. At you, you'll be blind. At you, you'll be blind. So therefore, it says the Nativ says the following. Kol bracha bayi shmira shelo yafchu leroetz chas v'shalom. Anything that is of a blessing needs to have boundaries so it would not be a stumbling block. So even if we're talking about a midah, a quality, that in its core it's a good midah, as we spoke before, it could become a bad midah, could become a bad thing. That's why we need to have the chesed to control the din, and that's why we need to have the din to control the chesed. Only then we create a balance. Of course, if it's not like this, it's bad. And that's what the Rambam showed us or taught us in Halachot Deot, Perek Aleph, Halachah Dalet. Haderech hayeshara hi midat beinonit shebechol de'a ve'de'a michol ha'deot sheyesh lo la'adam. A person has to go into the middle path of his extreme opinions. והיא הדעה שהיא רחוקה משתי הקצוות, ריחוק שווה. That is equally apart from the extreme opinions, ואינה קרובה לא לזו ולא לזו. Exactly in the middle. And it's a very important midah. שלא יאמר אדם, so a person could not say, הגעתי אל המנוחה ואל הנחלה. I reach menucha, rest, nachala, my family estate. Or in other words, I made a mistake. Right? There's still no geula. The menucha and the nachala refers to the geula. Now it's very interesting because I'm going to bring you something that is brought in Shuti Abiya Omer. Michelek Vav Ora Chaim Siman Mem Aleph. He was medactic, he was very particular to call this name only not the Geula itself, Sofa Geula, the end of the process of Geula. Geula is not going to come, okay, Geula, that's it, we're done. Even Geula is a process. And what he says, and I'm quoting, Ho'il ve'adain rav haderech lefanenu, still we have a long way to go. To reach that final destination, hen mipchina medinit, from a political vetzvait and a military perspective, hen mipchina musarit, whether it's a moral point of view, veruchanit, and a spiritual point of view. Therefore, hold your seats, en chiyuv ligmor et ha'alel bebracha. Ad sof ha'tikun. Lachen, therefore, what we need to do is we need to develop a
Shuvah.
Nah. A different sense. A different sense. We need to develop a different sense. And I'm going to tell you what the sense is. Astonishment. Hitpa'alut, you can't make shuvah even if you don't have this, and I'll tell you why. And that hitpa'alut will come from hitbonenut, from looking. You need to look. You need to think. And you need to be grateful. In other words, we call it hakarat hatov, for what we have. If you don't think for a second and look at what you have and look who gave it to you, if you don't stop to look at this, you're never going to be astonished at how great God has done for you, how great he is. I'm not talking about the creations of rivers or understanding how the heart of the bee works, on the kindness that Ribbono Shel Olam had for me. And we all, thank God, are blessed. Because we know each and every, unless we are like pathetic liars, we all know what we are all about. We all know why do we do the things we do and we don't do the things we should. And yet, God, Ribbono Shel Olam, gives us and gives us and gives us. You complain that you live in a one-bedroom apartment? Do you know where your grandmother used to live? You know where your great-grandmother used to live? You know what it is to go to an outhouse when you need to go in a... You know, there were places in the world that it was so cold in the winter. And it was so brutal in the winter. And they had an outhouse. They used to tie a rope around the waist to be able to go to the bathroom and then to be able to come back because it's a blizzard. And we are complete. We have sensual. Yeah, you see? I'm not making it up. We have essential, central AC, central heat, hot water, cold water, everything. So that's you need to look. Now, there is a very famous kuntrus or writing that, and all this stuff was already was mentioned, and he goes into detail into that, what is so-called kuntras ha'itpa'alut. The kuntras ha'itpa'alut was written by Rav Dov Ber Schneer, also known as the Admor Ha'emtzai, the middle Admor, which was the son of Baal HaTanya, and the one who continued his way in the dynasty of Chabad. That Kuntras was sent to his Hasidim in the year Tafkuf Ein Dalet, was 1813, about a year after the Baal HaTanya died. And this Kuntras was sent to all the Hasidim, and it deals with the ways to really astonish yourself in the heart and in your mind, in the machshava, according to the way of Chabad, but it doesn't make a difference because in this thing, everything is good. And he explains the way to actually interact with the, for the Adama Benoni, for the average person, to interact with Hashem. According to that, that itpa'alut, that level of astonishment, is achieved by contemplation of how Ribbono Shel Olam conducts the world. Look at the world. Now you understand why I tell you, go out to nature. Go look, go appreciate. Look at Hanhagat HaRibbono Shel Olam Ba'olam, how HaKadosh Baruch Hu conducts the world. And of course he cries on the situation that most of the Hasidim are not awakened to this astonishment. And of course he brings the reasons for that. It could be Parnasa, it could be greed. You put your guard down, you don't work on yourself, you don't ask, you don't appreciate. I mean, Ribbono Shel Olam, if you want to appreciate a person, if you want to love a person, how you love your wife? Or you know, because you look at this and you say, oh wow, she's really a tzaddeket. Look, she first of all puts up with me. That's already something. Don't tell her that, but you know what I'm saying?
It's still recording, Rabbi.
All right, still recording? That's okay. Whatever. Right, you look at her, she puts up with me. She raises my kids, she brings me kosher food all the time, she sends me to learn, you know. Wow. When you understand that, only after you look and at the beginning we're blind. We married our wife. Oh, wow, she's beautiful. But then that external beauty disappears and become true beauty of action. When you see Manau Maaseya, when we sing the praise for the wife, or Eshet Chayil Mimtza, look at what she is. She's Baalat Chesed. She's kind. She gives. She takes care of people. You know, everything. And then you could become one with it. You cannot fulfill Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad, the oneness of the love of Hashem, unless you first of all stop 1 second and appreciate what HaKadosh Baruch Hu does to you or for you. We don't. We take everything for granted. Well, you light patrol over there. So now, so he explains that. And of course the Sefer is divided into different parts. And I would recommend to you to read it. I put it on the Yeshiva chat in English. You can read it so you don't say, I just tell you things. I actually sent it to you that you could read it. The Hebrew, by the way, is very difficult. It's not an easy text. It requires you to think, but it's a wonderful, wonderful work of art that he put together. It's an unbelievable work. I love it. It's one of my favorite readings. So all of a sudden, you could understand how you should act in life, and in order not to be stuck in this time loop that we all stuck in, right? And in this time loop, there's no meaning to life. You're doing the same thing over and over and over again and over and over and over again without meaning. You kind of stuck within this life. You don't realize it, but you're stuck within the misery of your life because life by itself has no value. There's no purpose. If there's no purpose, there's no value. And if not, it's just stuck. And we need to understand. Even if I just, I mean, not even, I mean, if I could only direct all my actions, for the sake of Ribbono Shel Olam, I mean, you know what a level a person can reach? All the things that we do, we won't do. We spoke about it today. When a person does an avera, he creates another eye on the body of Malach HaMavet to see him. We spoke about this today. So we don't do it. We're going to close all his eyes. We're going to make Malach HaMavet blind to you. He won't see what you do. And that's how you get life. When we spoke about Moshe Rabbeinu, how Moshe Rabbeinu, Malach HaMavet couldn't reach him, couldn't touch him. Why? Because he couldn't see anything wrong with his actions. Exactly it. So we need to understand that. And we need to all of a sudden could understand and appreciate kama gdolim ma'aseh chachamim, how great and amazing our rabbis, which gave us fences and boundaries. Why? Because it says, asu siag la Torah. Even the Torah needs boundaries in order for us to operate. We need to know what the boundaries. Here came the conservative reform. They cut on the boundaries. Then everybody's off the cliff. If it wasn't for Chachamim, and in a way we are the continuation of this unbroken chain of becoming, how should I call it? Fence workers. But for Ribono Shel Olam, and you should become rabbis, and you should become knowledgeable, and you should have the courage to do, because it's not for you, you do it. You do it for Ribono Shel Olam, you do it for Am Yisrael. If you really care about the Jews, learn where the boundaries are so they can operate. But it's as wide as the ocean, but even the mighty ocean has boundaries. Sheneemar she'amar lo olamo dai. Don't expand. So there are boundaries. The biggest ocean ends at the shore. So even an ocean has it. But the Torah is like an ocean. So we need Chachamim. We need the fences of Chachamim. We don't need to cut things and say, oh, I don't want to keep second days of Galuyot. Second day of Galuyot, guess what? Who said that? The rabbis? Good. I'll even keep it with more passion than the first day. People don't understand. People don't understand, and it's not, people don't act like it's because of some bad quality in them. It's simply because of ignorant. Being ignorant. Who wants to be an ignorant? Yeah, everybody wants to be intellectual. Well, start with what you know. Teach. If you're about to marry a woman who does not, in her agenda, is for you to seriously learn, I'll tell you this, leave me from shidduch crisis, leave me from all this baloney. Don't marry her. Because she's supposed to push you to learn. What are you doing home? Go learn, go teach, do something. But sit with me, do what? Play mahjong? Or shachma, chess, or like, what should we do, poker? That's what I married you for. Not being able to learn, when you are not actively learning, needless to say teaching, but learning, you're basically handing your neshama to Malach HaMavet as a gift. Because you don't know what to do. And if you don't know what to do, you're going to fail. No such thing. You be very careful who you marry. You be very careful. I don't care what shidduchim, kol shatchanim. Everybody nia li pitom shatchan. It's like a bar,
Jesus.
You bet, you're right. I agree with you. So now, everything all of a sudden, and by the way, and that's what it says, to be in motion all the time, to move, to be in motion all the time, not to develop spiritual rust. That's what we have, spiritual rust. We need like a major WD-40 to work. We're so rusted spiritually. We don't have this tnua. We know that the Chachamim tell us, the Malachim in Shamayim, they're all spiritual. They're moving, v'nayim, they're always moving. Ratzov, v'shov, aloch, v'bad, they're always in movement. Don't be benachat, right now I'm going to sit down, I'm going to have my Dos Equis and a little tingle, a little like this, going to relax. There's no such thing. Rabbi, I need to cool off and chill out. Chill out in the grave. We're going to be very cold. As long as the neshama pumping into you, you create energy, you need to be moving. Moving all the time. And by the way, that's what it is. And how do we start our day? And it starts with something very simple, saying thank you. Your day starts with Modeh ani lefanecha melech chai v'kayam. She'echzarta b'nishmati. I don't even take the fact that I got in the morning, up in the morning, I don't take it for granted. I say, Ribono Shel Olam, thank you. Why? Because I understand. He doesn't owe me anything. I need to say thank you. When you start to say thank you, when you start to look at things, all of a sudden, everything becomes different. Everything has a value. There is a meaning to my life. Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave me my neshama back. Why did he do that? Well, apparently I need to do something. What do I need to do? What do I need to do? What? To do manicure. I have to pay back. How am I going to do it? Help other people. Do what Hashem wants me to do. It is very simple. So to live in shalom is to live in harmony. It is to go with the flow of life, not to do what everybody else do. To go with the energy of life, not to stop and to freeze in one place and okay, I'm in retirement now, I'm doing nothing. I cannot wait for retirement. Why are you going to do retirement? Oh, nothing, I'm just going to sit down. You know what happens to people who retire and end up doing nothing? They die. And they die quick. Because there's no meaning for your life. You can tell me to die out of, you know. But I thought all your life you want to chill out. What happened?
And Zuzah,
exactly. But Baruch HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, what are you here for? To create manure. A cow is better than you. You cannot even create manure. What are you here for? They have to become fat to eat all day long. And then, right? Different ways for HaKadosh Baruch Hu to take you. So, let's talk, you understand? So now let's talk about the romach of Pinchas. Let's talk about the spear of Pinchas. So there are many issues regarding that spear. And it says in the Zohar that the letter Mem is right in the hands of Malach HaMavet. Because Mem is the middle of the alphabet. And he wants people to use the letter Vav and the letter Tav, and this is what he did to Chava as well. Right? Because it says, you know, that's how he lied to her, and that's how he got her. And it says, "V'tikach mipiryo v'tochal, v'titen gam le'isha ima." And she gave to Adam. So Malach HaMavet, which is the snake, which is the Yetzer Hara, caught it in a second, and he connected Mem, the letter Mem, and then Vav and Tav, that she says, right? And he brought death into a reality of life. Then, you know, he took the opportunity. He waited for it to fall. And the Zohar continues, it says, that when Pinchas saw the letter Mem floating up in the air, above the heads of Am Yisrael, he took the letters Ruach, Resh, Vav, Chet, Ruach, spirit, and he connected it to the Mem, and that's how he got the word Romach, also the word Chomer. And he put it together and he did Kriyat Shema, and he says Kriyat Shema, right? Now in Kriyat Shema we know there are Ramach, 248 what?
Words.
Ramach Evarim, right? So Ramach, Romach, it's the same letter. And that is what we call Cheref Pifiyot, the double-edged sword that he took against the Satan. And that's why when a person has Mezikim, right? Some kind of bad things, what do? You have a mezuzah in your house. What do you have in a mezuzah? Shema Yisrael. The Shmirah comes from Shema Yisrael. So, and by doing so, he brought the Shekhinah back that was removed from Am Yisrael. He kind of brought it back. And the Romach we say, which is Ramach Evarim, when a person says Kriyat Shema appropriately, that's why it's important to say Kriyat Shema Bekavana, with an appropriate, you know, intent. Kol HaTikunim, everything, from the whole entire thing. Whether it's your own Ramach Evarim of your own individual thing, or the Tikkun of the Tzura of the Adam in the spiritual form, is all being fixed. That is all the, when we do that, what's the fixing that we're doing? We take all the things that are apart and we put them then together. These are the people who wanted to make the Peirud, the separation in Am Yisrael. These are the people who divide and conquer. That's why I hate the term, you know, Sfardim, Hasidim, Ashkenaz, Mashkenaz. We're Jews. You have to understand that. It doesn't make a difference. Those terminologies of I am this and I am that, it just shows that you're weak. What's wrong with being a Jew? I'm Shomer Torah Mitzvot, I'm a Jew. Why do you need to add on, oh, I'm Hasidish Jew. I am, well, why, what's wrong with just being a Jew? I don't see anything wrong with that. So we need to create this keruv, the closeness. That's the tikkun. So when we keep on dividing, we are not fixing, we are continuing the destruction. Beit HaMikdash was a body that put all the Jews together. Everybody. There wasn't like one day for Sfardim, one day for Ashkenazim, one day for Temanim, one day for this, Hungarian, Galiciana. That's nonsense. Everybody, call! Everybody, the words in call includes everybody. And that's what we call Klal Yisrael. So by the acts of Pinchas, there was a tremendous chibur on Am Yisrael, and there was the Shechina came back, and there was the Kapara, there was the atonement of putting together. So after the act of Pinchas, it says, Vayidaber Hashem el Moshe lemor, and Hashem says to Moshe, Tzeror et ha-midyanim. Tzeror et ha-midyanim? Go after them. Ve'ikitar otam, and you should hit them. You should hit them hard. Why? Ki tzorerim im lachem. They are your enemies. Benochleem asher nichlu lachem. With the tricks in which they created to you. Al davar peor. For the idol worshipping of peor. And do you know the idol worship of peor? I have news for you. Exists. I told you this many times. Exists until today. You guys don't know. What was the avodah peor? The avodah peor is, you take some diuretics, you go to the statue that has his mouth open, and you defecate all over the act, all over the statue. I said, that's what it is? No, it's just the act. But what's behind the act? You know, if a person, we today, you know, we go to the bathroom, it's a private thing. We know Lehavdil, Shaul HaMelech was such a tzanua person, he would walk as a king out of the camp to go, when he needed to go to the bathroom. So when a person does that in public, in the open, it means that it's like, I don't care. I don't care. I don't care about you. I don't care about you. I don't care about anybody. And I'm going to show you that. I'm going to do this right in front of everybody. That's right. That selfishness that only me exists until today. The core of the idea is still until today. And therefore the Torah says that we need to revenge those Midianim. We need to remove all the people that mistake, that blemish had occurred from them. And we know that, of course, the Torah is not only the Pshat. The Torah is much more than that. But we're also talking about here about energies, about movements, about powers that are acting in the soul of the person as well. Now, and the shame, the name Midian comes from the same shoresh of dimyon, imagination. Imagination. In each and every one of us has the power of imagination is a great thing. And you know what's the biggest crime of our generation? That we took away, and that's the danger of playing computer games. That's the danger of letting kids watching TV and all these things. Do you know why? Because you are killing their imagination. You are taking their mind, the greatest tool that God gave us after free choice, and you implanting in them your imagination. And therefore they can think for themselves. They need to be fed ideas all the time. And this is how they corrupt our children. Stay away from TV. Stay away from the media. Read a book. When you read a book, you have your own imagination. You read a book, you watch the movie, it's not the same thing. Why? And usually your book, when you read it, was better than a movie. Why? Because it was your idea. Your idea. So now, It could be koach bone, it could be a build-up thing, or it could be a destructive. When it was my imagination and I put boundaries on it and I made it work for me, it was a good thing. We're building. We got to make a wonderful world. But when it's I'm implanting my crooked idea into you, it's a destructive matter. And I'm doing so to control you and to destroy you. And we need to use our imagination for Avodat Hashem. Why? Adame le'elyon. I should contemplate on having imagination what HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants from me. Adame, I'm going to compare myself to Ribono Shel Olam. Ma'u chanun, afatach chanun. As it says in Sefer Yeshaya in Isaiah 14, verse 14. And why? And it says over there that we need to be careful from our false imaginations that remove us deliberately from the good way. And that's what Rav Nachman says, that in our generation, the name of the Yetzer Hara hu Koach HaMedame. Imagination. Fantasies. La La Lands. That puts ideas into the people's mind of false ideas. And it deceives them, and it causes them to be completely lost within the mud of Chomer, of materialism. Chomer, Romach, same thing again. That's why we need to remove the Midianim. We need to remove those false ideas and imaginations from us, to remove that negative force of that destructive force of imagination of others within us. We need to remove it completely, and we need to connect ourselves to the Torah. In general, you know, Chachamim tells us that the real control of life should be that a person would have a clarity of the mind, clear understanding that he should see the real reality. Not the imaginative reality, not what people wanted you to see, but rather what you need to see as the way it is. Now, I just want to tell you, I'll finish with this, even though I'm not a big fan of gematria, it's just a little idea. The word shalom, the gematria, the numerical value of shalom, is 376. Of course, 376 is one more than 375, one and one less than 378. Seven. But let's concentrate. Amazing, isn't it? But let's look at 376. The gematria of 76 is the word shalom is Ohale Shem. What it was in Ohale Shem? Torah. You want to have peace? You want to have clarity? Lech le Ohale Shem, go learn Torah. I'll give you another one. The same Oto gematria. Also, shalom Odeh Shemecha. I would thank your name, Hashem. You cannot thank Hashem unless you start to realize it. You are in internal peace, internal harmony. Also, Lehavdil, the other side of that, right, is Bnei Korach. Bnei Korach, Korach himself brought Peirud. His children said to Tehillim. Bnei Korach, 376. The same thing, the Gematria of Hashevach Lakel, thank God, is also 376. You want to know what peace is? Shalom, according to peace? Hey, not a problem. The gematria, v'haya b'aniach Hashem, yudke vavke, lecha michol oivecha, and God will let all your enemies to the side. And how that will happen? It's not going to be happening because we're going to sign a peace treaty. It's going to happen because we're going to do what God wants us to do. Im shamot ishmeru lechol mitzvotai asher anochi mitzavetchem hayom, v'natati shalom ba'aretz. Then, that's going to happen. Another one, Vayireh Lehem Kvod Hashem, is also the same gematria of 376. And the last one is, again, Hashem, Yudke Vavke, Imloch Leolam Vaed. May God be your king forever and ever. Amen. Shabbat Shalom.
Amen.
Shkoyach, hi.